Hello, everybody. It's Lance and Kurt coming to you from Austin, Texas for Keltner and Cole. And I'm looking at my good friend Mitch Colby's Mod Machine amp. And I gotta tell you, there's a lot of knobs and switches on this thing, but you know, it took me about 5 minutes last night to get it where I live, which is what you just heard, right? So it's kind of like the basis for all Texas rock and AC/DC is this sort of tone, and that's with a freaking Telecaster, right? Yeah. Even it sounds like their amps, doesn't it?
It sounds like their amp.
It could get none more like their amp, could it?
I don't think it could.
None more. Okay, so let's run down the controls on this
thing. That's not going back.
I hope not. Hey, Mitch, can I keep this? Anyway, look. So we have an emphasis and shift. There's a four-way emphasis, which the emphasis is sort of the top end where that focuses on the bright cap. So watch, we go. Keep it on four, which, you know, obviously anytime we're doing anything, the most rock I can make something is where I keep it. Four is where I keep it. To me, what it sounds like, and Mitch can say whatever he wants about this, but, you know, as you go back from 4-3-2-1, it almost goes back to the older ones. It almost sounds like a JTM 45 or something. As opposed to all the way over at four, where it does. To me, it sounds like a metal panel, more of a metal panel. And then the shift, we hear what that does. Here's in the first position. It changes the mid-range, okay? And I've got it in the fattest setting. Now, you've also got your exciting volume, treble, mid, and bass. Whenever I grab any amp with EL34s, which this has a pair, is I always run the treble a little above half sometimes. The mid I kind of crank up and the bass I pull down a bit. Now you have a kind of a master section that has a volume, a presence, a high trim, and a power amp volume. And the cool thing about it is we're barely bumping this thing now. It can get a lot louder than this. And it's pretty loud in the room right now. But it's reasonable. You could play this in a club, you could play in a bar, and you probably wouldn't have people bitch too much. Now, the high trim, we'll show you what that does. Now you can bring in just the amount you want of that thing. Now, even before we get to the back, I want to show you one other thing, a couple other things actually. We have a loop on off, and it's foot switchable as well. So it's got a effects loop on this with a send and a return. So you can use it with, you know, use it with pedal effects, you can use it with rack effects. And it sounds really good. It's a very transparent loop. But here's where the fun really gets cranking for us rock musicians. There is a stage two gain. So you basically have an entire other gain structure that you can add onto this thing. So just when you thought it was safe to go outside, you're going, oh well, you know, I've got my Malcolm Young sound, but how am I going to get that push over the edge, that bump up to 11?
Now add Angus.
The second gain stage. So you got. Then back to Angus. Right?
Beautiful.
Ta-da! Okay, now, so hang on. I have to tell you about some other goodies. On the back of this amp, which we'll show you, obviously, pictures of in a minute, you got switches, okay? And there's several different, excuse me, Mitch, I'm gonna have to read this. Basically, there are different modes. There's pentode, triode, cathode, and fixed bias. And basically, that's gonna control how much output power you have. So you can even bring this thing down further. So without me looking too ridiculous, leaning it over. Okay, so on the back, I've been using this fixed bias and pentode mode, but you can also switch, like here's how it's been sounding, right? Switch to triode. Considerably quieter, right?
Oh yeah.
Then you go to cathode bias. Like it with pentode and cathode bias.
That's my favorite right there.
Right, so we're back to the front. And so although this is not a channel switching amp, really, there's a ridiculous number of tones in this amplifier. You can get everything from JTM 45 to 45 100 to 68 plexi, 71 metal panel, and then even like that but modded sort of a vibe. So, you know, like I've got this sort of in metal panel mode. But just flip stage two on. So look, I'm gonna go get a humbucker guitar just because I'm interested to hear it that way. Will you guys wait for a second? I'll be right back. Hang on. Pow, and we're back. And look, we've got a True Temperament guitar here. You are not having an acid flashback. These are the actual frets on this guitar. We'll tell you about that in a different video. But for now, I wanna hear what the Colby sounds like in the regular mode, not second stage gain, with a humbucker in the bridge. So it. Well, watch, just for fun, let's do this. Let's clean this up a whole bunch. So it almost does that whole sort of JTM 45 clean thing. And then I want to go back to my favorite sort of settings here. And turn the gain stage on for all the fun that you could possibly have with a Marshall style amp. Thank you. And the Norse floor is not bad. Listen.
No.
What? That's with the gang stage off. It's nearly quiet.
And it smells good, too.
It smells lovely, and it's beautiful. So, guys, look. Colby, Mod Machine, Mitch Colby, Marshall Genius. We can say M style or Marshall. You know, I mean, the guy knows his stuff when it comes to those kinds of amps, right?
Yeah.
And if you want an amp that does it all in that family of sounds, this is the amp to get. I mean, you can get other amps from Colby that do less, but if you want one that does all the Marshall style sounds in one box, wow, the Mod Machine. He wants it, and we'll ask about that. So, guys, thanks for watching, as always. And I'm so happy to be here. Kurt's happy to be here. And we're happy to be here for Mitch Colby and his Mod Machine slamming sound and amp. And yes, I may put effects on a little bit of what I played just then. And if I did, you're going to go, I thought I heard reverb. The amp doesn't have reverb. Yeah, I know. I have a Pro Tools rig. The reverb is built into the Pro Tools rig. So, if I put anything on there, we'll warn you in writing, okay? So, kids, have a great day. Buy amps from Mitch Colby. We're giving you all his information right here. And listen out as we have fun on the way out here. Bye-bye.